Hello, 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 and welcome to Project WWN presenting the Cosmic Carnival, the best of the junior heavyweights. And ladies and gentlemen, we have a very special tournament season set up for our viewers this summer. Ladies and gentlemen, we are introducing the Cosmic Carnival, a triple threat round robin matchup, a tournament where we are going to determine the best of the junior heavyweights in the Worldwide Wrestling Network. Nine individuals will be competing in this round robin Robinson's Rules tournament for an opportunity at the Worldwide Wrestling Network Junior Heavyweight Championship. And as we can see, ladies and gentlemen, we have in alphabetical order our contestants, participants' entrance into the Cosmic Carnival. At the top, we have Ahan, former Junior Heavyweight Champion, Andy Watts, coming to us from Terra Nova Wrestling, a very interesting debut. We have a returning Bradley Zametti. We have last season's standout, JC, the Kitsune King, Joey Dynamite, from Guerrilla Warfare Wrestling, PK King, the very, very bombastic Pretty Ricky Yamamoto, the guy with something to prove, the man with the chip on his shoulder, Spike, and Tyree Lawson, who is going to bring some riz to this tournament standing. And ladies and gentlemen, we have got a lot of things happening in the Worldwide Wrestling Network, but we want to focus on the best of the junior heavyweights. And so tonight we have our qualifying match. Basically, what's going to happen in this, ladies and gentlemen, is this is a 10-person gauntlet. It is going to start out with two individuals, and then the rest will make their way at random. The last competitor is the junior heavyweight champion, Mascaras de los Dioses. And Mascaras de los Dioses has one thing in mind, and that is to show up all of the other potential competitors. But he has very special, qualifications here. He has very special setup in this tournament qualifier. Basically, he is playing the spoiler. If he eliminates any of the individuals left in the match, their standings disappear. Their qualifying points that they've earned, they are going to the bottom and being seeded, and depending on order of elimination, they will be dropped to the bottom. The first person he eliminates would be 9, and then 8, and then so on and so forth, because that means that those lasted longer with the champ. But the regular rules of this qualifier is that any fall gains someone 5 points, and the most points get you seated, and the least points get you seated first, and the least points get you seated last. It is Mascaras de los Dioses who is playing the spoiler in this match. So anything can happen. We can have an incredible run and have it taken away by the junior heavyweight champion. Now remember, this is all for an opportunity for the junior heavyweight championship. So ladies and gentlemen, Mascaras de los Dioses has a invested interest here to basically put people in the bottom seed. Okay, to get inside their head, I can't believe that the championship committee has come up with such an incredible idea, and we are going to take this match straight to ringside so that we can get this cosmic carnival on the way. And ladies and gentlemen, let me remind you, I am Remarkable Randall Reigns, and just giving you a shot of the rules here. Two superstars start. Every 2 minutes, another superstar will enter. Elimination can occur by pinfall or submission. Each elimination is worth 5 points. The most points at the end of the qualifier is the number one seed. The least points, the number nine seed. And the last opponent is Mascaras de los Dioses, who, if he eliminates anyone, they are dropped to the bottom of the pile. And starting out this match is former junior heavyweight champion, Ahat. Mascaras de los Dioses defeated Ahat for the junior heavyweight championship, and it makes sense that he is starting out this qualifying match, but he is going to have to outlast nine other individuals in order to determine his opportunity in this round robin tournament. Now, round robin means, ladies and gentlemen, that basically, everybody is going to face everyone. But because of our triple threat rules and Robinson rules here in this tournament, basically two falls per triple threat match, that means that some folks can earn double points. That means that potentially competitors can earn at least 5 points each for each match. And here comes PK King from Guerrilla Warfare Wrestling and the Eminence Network. And will a king be born in the Cosmic Carnival? PK King starting things out against former champion Ahat here. And every 2 minutes, folks, a new competitor will come in. Pinfall or submission eliminates a competitor. And every elimination gives 5 points. And PK King with an incredible entrance here. And here we go, folks, the Cosmic Carnival Qualifier. Ahat versus PK King. Referee's calling for the bell. Here we go, folks. And wait a minute, out of the gate, PK King running with that dragon twist cover. One, two, three. Took out by Ahat. This is definitely putting the former champion in harm's way here. A big move by PK, following up with the moonsault. Go over the corner. And again, pinfall and submission will eliminate. And King stomping away on Ahat, and oh, nice combination there with the knee and the poison rana. And King going to the corner What's he got in mind here? Oh, big drop kick right to the middle of the back. And now, again, stomping away on the former junior heavyweight champion, M.A. Hahn, our longest reigning junior heavyweight champion in the Worldwide Wrestling Network. And, but due to the random nature of the seating here for this qualifier, Hahn is at a disadvantage. And so many covers by P.K. King here, trying to embarrass the former champion. Nice shot there by, oh! Wait a minute. Hahn up and down with that lifting single underhook DDT. And our third competitor is headed down in 2-1. Wait a minute. Here comes Joey Dynamite. The Kitsune King, and we have heard a lot about this junior heavyweight. And wait a minute, man, starting things out with a clash style pin right on the former junior heavyweight champion. Three and shots fired by Joey Dynamite. That's five on the board for Joey. Five on the board for Joey Dynamite. And here we go, Joey bringing things back in, and it's caught by PK. PK up and down. Joey, probably, I think, honestly, probably the smallest individual in this junior heavyweight tournament here, but it's, like we said, it's not the size of the dog in the fight. It's the size of the fight in the dog. And the Kitsune King is bringing full force to PK here. PK King. Wait a minute. Oh, caught in that arm drag. Kip up and a drop kick. The PK King and the Kitsune King squaring off in this one-on-one respite here. Oh! Up, PK! As Joey Dynamite waiting on the next competitor. Has PK grounded, and here comes Bradley Zimetti. And Bradley making his way down to the ring. And wait a minute. Bradley starting things out with a Zimetti driver. On to Joey Dynamite. One, two, no! Bradley Zimetti has been missing from the Worldwide Wrestling Network for quite a while. Now making his return in the Cosmic Carnival. Welcome back, Bradley Zimetti, facing off against Joey Dynamite and PK King. Bradley Zimetti, number four in this random draw qualifier, and Bradley sent over the top rope. Joey fighting off against PK, dragging PK King to the corner, stomping to the gut. What's he got planned here? Wait a minute, lifting, and a DDT from the corner. And Bradley, out of pure spite there, breaking up that pin Joey Dynamite. Joey with the Bulldog. Puts down Bradley. Remember, folks, Joey Dynamite is the only one that has put points up on the board, eliminating a Han. PK King with the cover on Joey. And whoa, moonsault there by Bradley. And oh, and it looked like Joey Dynamite was attempting that running. Polish Hammer, but here comes entrance number five, Andy Watts from Terra Nova Wrestling. And Andy Watts has been tearing it up in Big H Productions and many, many other beds. And Watts is going to be interesting to watch in this round robin tournament. Watts already coming in attempting to pin Bradley Zanetti and taking the fight to PK King. PK has been in this match the longest. Oh! Drove down PK with the knee. And oh! He dropped by Zanetti. Joey Dynamite with the spinning elbow taking down Bradley Zanetti. And what is going on here? Andy trying to figure, whoa, Bradley. Hits the backcourt kick on Joey Dynamite. This is leaving PK Keith standing. Wait a minute. Zanetti driver. 1, 2, 3, and Bradley Zanetti. Richard here. Yeah, tied up with Joey Dynamite and Bradley Zanetti for our top spot right now. And PK King and Ahan right now in the bottom rankings. Due to getting no eliminations. I hate to see that happen to both Ahan and PK. But unfortunately, in the qualifier, it is how strong you are showing here. But at the end of the day, oh, caught with that. Snake eyes, that's a... Oh, why can't I think of that move name? Whatever. Andy Watts just caught Joey by the throat. Now Bradley Zanetti. Bradley. Oh, caught with that running roundhouse, that shining wizard. And whoa, Andy Watts looking to take out Zanetti. Zanetti gets the shoulder up. And here comes, oh, Joey Dynamite attacking the leg. Almost threw a cross body on that leg. Andy Watts ferociously fighting. Look at this combination by Bradley taking up Joey Dynamite, the Canadian backbreaker, right neckbreaker. Andy wrestling a bit of a different style in junior heavyweight division, more of a hard-nosed grappler in this setup. That is one of the things that I love about the Cosmic Carnival. We are bringing in junior heavyweights who wrestle many different styles, from showmen to grapplers to high flyers to luchadors to junior to even, we've got some light heavyweight powerhouses. I know that sounds like an oxymoron. Wait a minute, at least not even a fireball. It is not effective, but the distraction allowed Andy Watts to take down both individuals. That fireball did not connect like Bradley wanted it to. And wait a minute, covered by Joey. 1, 2, no! All three of these competitors are still in this matchup. And here comes Ricky Yamamoto. Pretty Ricky making his way down to the ring. And in any other situation, I think that Bradley Zanetti's and Ricky Yamamoto would get on fairly well. Both have a sense of whimsy and party about them. But here they are facing off against each other in this qualifying matchup. And wait a minute. Bradley Zanetti has Andy wrapped up. And Joey Dynamite still holding out strong. Joey Dynamite is the one now, the longest individual in this matchup with the most time, started in at number 3. And wait a minute, package pile driver to Andy Watts. And Ricky Yamamoto, Northern Light suplex. And wait a minute, nose clip there, followed by the slap right to the face. Oh, Yamamoto with a super kick. 1, 2, 3. And Bradley Zanetti eliminated. His night is capped off at 5 points. And 5 points added to Ricky Yamamoto. Oh, wait a minute. Yamamoto and Dynamite just missed one another with attacks there. And Ricky Yamamoto. Wait a minute. Look at the strength of Ricky Yamamoto. Whoa. Shining Wizard. Joey covers Ricky. 2. Oh, ow! Hold on by Andy Watts, taking down Joey Dynamite, dead center of the ring. Ricky Yamamoto swinging. Whoa, nice reversal there by Watts. Watts, oh! Single knee corebuster, but wait a minute, we've seen the clash. The clash connects. 1, 2, 3, and that's 10 points for Joey Dynamite. And 0 for Andy Watts. A disappointing showing by Andy Watts. We know that he is incredibly capable. We've seen him across other feds be a force to be reckoned with. And tonight, just not his night. Right now, Joey Dynamite is the man to beat. And Dynamite has Yamamoto. Got that arm twisted. Oh, slap to the chest. Springboard. Oh, arm drag. Sky Twister arm drag by Dynamite. Going for the cover. 2. And it is only a 2 count here. The frustration. Joey Dynamite would like to be able to recover just a little bit before the final 4 make their way down to the ring. And, oh, frog splash by Joey Dynamite. And we're at the 10 count here. And here comes JC, a standout of last season of Project WWN. JC, an unconventional light heavyweight, wrestles more of that power style, and the Kitsune King is not wasting any time, but got that distraction there with Yamamoto, with JC's entrance. Yamamoto with a drop kick, but Joey Dynamite gets the kick out. JC, big tossing jerk. And wait a minute, powerbomb! JC walking in, taking out the big competition, but Yamamoto with a lagger bomb of his own. Springboard leg drop. And JC, after that tremendous show of strength there, now is down. And wait a minute. Yamamoto, taken down. And it is Joey Dynamite lifting up. Falcon Arrow. But JC running through. He's got a little bit of height, a little bit of muscle on these junior heavyweights. He's at the higher end of that 225 spectrum. And a jackhammer. 1, 2, 3. And Ricky Yamamoto, see you later. You only got 5 points. And here comes Spike. Spike has a little bit of little man syndrome, and that makes JC the perfect foil here. Spike gonna be coming in like a house of fire. Misses with that cyclone kick, but hits it with that basement drop kick. And wait a minute, JC working the arm of Spike. And we have 3 more entrants in this match, including Mascaras de los Dioses, the Worldwide Wrestling Network champion, the junior heavyweight champion, Spike, doing everything he can to do damage to Joey Dynamite. And wait a minute. Locking in that Dragon Sleeper, and Joey taps. Joey's had enough. Joey is still the man to beat with 2 eliminations, 10 points. And Spike with that crossbody onto JC. Spike and JC one-on-one here. I thought for half a second that a body block had occurred there. And no. Spike taken down with a backbreaker in the clothesline. And now JC laying in some big damage. Single knee right to the face with recoil. 2 and no. Spike gets the shoulder up. And what's JC got planning here? JC, oh, wait, no! DDT by Spike! And, oh! Nice combination! By Spike! Spike with a German! And Spike. Oh! What a moonsault! What torque! And wait a minute. And here, oof! Faceplant there by Spike. Couldn't quite get it. And here comes Tajir Lawson. Our final entrant in this qualifier. Lawson has overcome a lot of adversity in his lifetime to get to where he is at. And now he is looking for an opportunity of championship gold. Lawson, the tallest individual in this matchup, getting rid of Spike. And now JC and Tajir going one-on-one here while Spike recovers on the outside. Big clubbing blow. And here we go. Take a look at this, ladies and gentlemen. JC with the Oklahoma Slam onto Spike. Oh, clothesline, but it misses. Nice punch to the back. Oh, Tajir misses with that springboard arm wrench into the hammerlock. Oh, arm breaker. Spike with the Anaconda Vice locking it in on JC, trying to eliminate who he thinks is the biggest problem in this match. And now going after Tajir Lawson, cyclone kick. And he really put his whole weight into that. 2-3 it. What an upset. Tajir Lawson literally just got out here and is eliminated with that cyclone kick by Spike. Holy crap! And here is the final entrant. Montezuma Cortez, formerly known as, now known as Mascaras de los Dioses. The Masks of the Gods. And the current Worldwide Wrestling Network Junior Heavyweight Champion, and Mascaras coming in a house of fire. And the Psycho Bomb on Spike. We're right for the cover. 1, 2, 3. And this is going to be Spike, after two eliminations, was eliminated by the champion. By the rules, that is putting him at seed number 9. And our final standings will be coming up after suit as this match is over. Mascaras de los Dioses is driving a back elbow onto JC. One, two, and almost eliminated. JC has really come in and shown his value here. And Mascaras de los Dioses up on the top, perched. And Cortez mounted and hopping down, waiting for JC to get back into the ring. We are down to JC and Montezuma Cortez, Mascaras de los Dioses. And take a look at JC. JC already eliminated two individuals in this match, has 5 points already. He has everything to lose in this matchup. MDLD is doing what he can to put JC in the bottom of the seed. JC using striking and power maneuvers, dropping the knee across the face and head of Mascaras de los Dioses. And Mascaras caught up in the ropes, and Mascaras is as tough as they come. Background training in Lucha Libre, but with a high-flying and technical side as well. Not your typical luchador when you think about what most Americans think when they think Lucha Libre. Most think high-flying and high risk-taking, and he does that, but his bread and butter is more grounded power moves in the vein of La Parca and Conan. That's where his major inspirations come from. La Parca, Conan, Pentagon, and the Mask of the Gods weighing in, kicks, and JC. Wait a minute, big splash by JC. JC going for the cover. One, two, and no. JC with that big icon splash. And, oh, nice combination, sliding into the lariat. And here he goes, JC. He might be going for a wipeout here. No, wipeout denied. And, whoa, do-si-do there. And, whoa, deep kick. And wait a minute. Oh, inside out into the face buster. Cover by Mascaras. One, two. Nice combination here, laying in these kicks and punches and chops, shades of Ultimo Dragon, and that shoot savant right to the stomach. JC trying to crawl up, springboard, wow. Bootlegged moonsault in the cover. One, two. JC has something to prove here in this qualifier. JC has survived here to the end, and right now he is sitting at 10 points, tied with Joey Dynamite and Spike, but Spike just got completely eliminated, just like JC did with that Canadian Destroyer. And JC getting the shoulder up after the Destroyer. Dragon Screw puts down Mascaras de los Dioses. And by that moment, JC, Irish Whip off the rope, and oh, Boss Man Slam! One, two, and getting that shoulder up, the left shoulder being left, there's still fight in the champion, and JC extending out with the splash. One, two, and another kick out. And yes, the Worldwide Wrestling Network Junior Heavyweight Champion was the last individual out, so he should be the freshest. He should have all of the advantages here. And that is what this entire Cosmic Carnival is about. It is about endurance. Drop down. Oh, with the elbow breaking up the offense there. And here come, wait a minute, JC. Oh, slamming Mascaras into the turnbuckle. Big right hands, multiple right hands, stomping away. And now, and JC showing off a little bit of that athleticism. JC signaling for a big finish, maybe. Irish Whip. And, oh, backbreaker. Oh, lariat to the back of the skull. And, wait. Ooh, JC deadlift. Oh, into the back suplex. JC trying to figure out, hey, what does he gotta do here to put down the champion and remain at the top of the seed list right now for the Cosmic Carnival? Because if Montezuma Cortez, if Mascaras, the Mask of the Gods, pins the shoulders down, JC will go into the number 8 seed. Oh! JC has everything to lose. Now remember, folks, this is going to be a Robinson's Rules tournament. This means that it'll be 2 out of 3 falls in a triple threat matches. Every single opponent, no matter where they seed, is going to face every other opponent. But these seeds are going to carry some weight because there's a mental advantage in knowing that you defeated a champion, that you defeated 3 other men, that you outlasted 9 other individuals to qualify for that number 1 seed. That is what JC, oh, hammering blow right to the sternum, is fighting for right now at the end of this Cosmic Carnival. There's nobody else coming out, ladies and gentlemen. It is only Mascaras de los Dioses and JC in these final innings of this match. Nice reversal and a gut kick. And wait a minute. JC, bam, rocking the champion. Big splash. Tidal wave style, and now we go for the cover. We must win it. Cover 1, 2, 3. And JC with the victory. JC is the number 1 seed for the Cosmic Carnival Robinson's Rules Round Robin Tournament. Congratulations, JC! Congratulations, JC! In just a moment, we will take a look at what our standings are for the Cosmic Carnival. And ladies and gentlemen, these are our standings for the Cosmic Carnival. We have JC at the top with 10 points. And the reason he is at the top is he eliminated Mascaras de los Dioses and defeated the champion. So he is the number one seed. And why is that different than Spike down here with his 10 points to qualify? Well, Spike got pinned by the Worldwide Wrestling Network heavyweight champion, Mascaras de los Dioses. Eliminated by the champion, you're at the bottom. Joey Dynamite, the Iron Man of the Gauntlet, he is in the number two slot, tied with JC with eliminations, but because he did not defeat the champion, Mascaras de los Dioses, well, that's all she wrote. Sayonara. And then Bradley Zimetti at the number three seed. Ricky Yamamoto at the number four seed. And then Ahan, Andy Watts, PK King, and Tajir Lawson. These are our seed rankings. So what this means is that in the matches to come, our first setup, we will see PK King, Tajir Lawson, and Spike, followed by Ricky Yamamoto, Ahan, and Andy Watts, and the main event of the first round of the Robinson's Rules Cosmic Carnival Triple Threat Tournament will be JC versus Joey Dynamite versus Bradley Zimetti, and that is going to be the lineup for our show next time. And we will have 9 shows that will revolve around the Cosmic Carnival, each with 3 Triple Threat Robinson's Rules match. And eventually, all of these competitors will face one another twice. And at the end, we will have total pointage for every single one of these individuals. The individual with the highest point values by the end of the tournament will face Montezuma Cortez one-on-one in a Robinson's Rules match for the Worldwide Wrestling Network Junior Heavyweight title. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, this has been Remarkable Randall Reigns, and we are signing off with from the Cosmic Carnival with Project WWWN. Check us out very soon for round 1 of the Cosmic Carnival.